Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Northwestern Oklahoma State University Choral Concert featuring the Northwestern Oklahoma State University Community Concert Choir, the Chorale, and the University Singers. It is my pleasure to present today's performance showcasing the very best of American music. In addition to our choral presentation, today's concert will also feature Grammy-nominated tenor Rodell Rosel. Mr. Rosel made his Metropolitan Opera debut in 2009. He has performed with the finest opera companies in America, including the Lyric Opera of Chicago, the Houston Grand Opera, and Santa Fe Opera, in addition to his Grand Prize Award from the Metropolitan Opera National Council. Mr. Rosel has received top awards from Palm Beach Opera Vocal Competition, as well as the People's Choice and President's Award from the Jose Iturbe International Music Competition. He is the recipient of many scholarships, including the National Academy of Recording Arts and Sciences, as well as the recipient of the prestigious Opera Buffs Career Achievement Award. We are fortunate to have him here tonight with us, and we are grateful that he has agreed to work with some of our students, singers, tomorrow for the President's Prize Vocal Competition, which will be held tomorrow evening at Northwestern's campus in the Fine Arts Building, Room 200. At this time, I'd like to ask you to please turn off all cell phones, sit back, relax, and please help me in welcoming Mr. Rodell Rosel and Mrs. Charlotte Parker.
Time and again I Raindrop when the summer shower is through, so voice within me keeps life is a little short-lived, I think, because of the pressures of Hollywood and, you know, even it's the pressure of being in show business. Hollywood kind of snatched him from the classical side just at the right time. It's, and for a younger generation, this was told to me by, let's just say, someone who was like a teenager during Byron's time. In the past, you know how we can listen to pop music, but there are certain explicit music that we're not allowed to? During that time, especially music majors or people who are, you know, playing piano, singing classically, they were only allowed to play, to listen to classical music, Strauss, even Mozart. They had to like really keep it a secret, listening to singers like Mario Lanza, because it was about love and romance. And now it's become the classical in our generation. So at least, you know, this was, I just want to compare. This was their Josh Groban in their time, and they just fell in love.
My love for no one else can hurt this love.
we continue getting ourselves situated, I'm going to talk a little bit about the next portion of our concert. During the 19th century, many musical landmarks were made in America. Lowell Mason introduced music into the public schools. The Yankee tunes and hymns were popular, as well as ragtime music. And during this time, slave spirituals and work songs became popular after the Civil War. Stephen Foster is considered the father of American music. Opening the choral portion of our concert tonight is the new Northwestern Community Choir, who will perform one of Foster's most popular pieces, Camptown Races. It is something that anyone can understand. Our next piece will be performed by the University Singers, and it is called Shenandoah. It is a traditional American folk song dating to the early 19th century, and the origin of the song is unclear. Some interpretations tell of a pioneer's nostalgia for the Shenandoah River Valley in Virginia. To our next spiritual, Elijah Rock. The constant exclamation of Elijah Rock in the basses and later in the tenors gives the sonic impression of a ring shout. The piece is filled with a pulsing energy during the chorus, and the tension eases and rebuilds again, only to bring us to the ending where the voices enter from lowest to the highest, saying, "I am coming up, Lord."
Thank you. Nice rock and rock.
They were facing at the time. Our next piece is a gospel song called City Called Heaven, featuring tenor soloist Isi Ofiu.
Thank you.
piece is called Climb Every Mountain from our next set of Broadway show tunes. It is a show tune from the 1950s by Rodgers and Hammerstein. The musical is called The Sound of Music. In this piece, the theme is an inspirational piece to encourage people to take every step towards attaining one's dream. This will be sung by the University Singers and accompanied by Miss Charla Parker.
Climb every
Rodgers and Hammerstein. Set in Oklahoma Territory outside of the town of Claremore in 1906, it tells a simple story of a cowboy and his romance with a farm girl. I understand that this is a pretty popular song about Oklahoma and our town, right? We like this song. If you've noticed, we have microphones set up all over the place. We are getting a professional recording done, and fortunately, we will have them available at the end of the semester. So if you'd like to purchase a copy of this evening's performance, that will be readily available for you. To get the best recording, however, I'm gonna ask that you, if you are tempted, refrain from clapping, refrain from singing during this piece, and I know it might be hard. However, I will make a deal with you. As soon as we're done with our piece, and we even have choreography for you, as soon as we're done, I will turn around and I will invite everybody to sing the chorus. How about that? We make that deal? Yes? Yes? Okay. Without further ado, here's your Oklahoma. Thank you.
side, yes, it's about Marie Antoinette. And basically, Marie Antoinette's ghost and other ghosts in the palace are roaming around, like we were talking about, it's like paranormal activity roaming around. But she's trapped because she's beheaded. Now, Beaumarchais, who is the author of famous stories like The Marriage of Figaro and Barbara Seville, his ghost is there, and he wants to save Marie Antoinette. So he writes an opera within the opera, and characters from both Marriage of Figaro and Barbara Seville are also reintroduced. Now, where do I come in? To save Marie Antoinette's soul, Count Almaviva, from both Marriage of Figaro and Barbara Seville, has these jewels that he needs to sell to bribe, I guess, whoever it is, so that she doesn't get beheaded. My character is Patrick Honoré Béjart, who is the right-hand man to Count. What he doesn't know is I'm a traitor, because I am in love with one of the characters. I think it's, Patrick is in love with the daughter of Figaro and Suzanne. So I'm doing something to corrupt everything. So basically, I'm going to steal the jewels so that I could, so that everyone's just distracted. And basically, the reason why it's Are You the Worm is, you hear it in the text, lion may roar, eagles may soar, and man may sail 1,000 seas, but the worm is. Basically, everything in the world would disappear, but the worm still survive. And that's the character of the country.
Thank you.
And he is often referred to as the Dean of American Composers. His sound has been said to evoke the vast American landscape and pioneer spirit.
Thank you.
gentlemen of the chorale will perform the next song, What Shall We Do with a Drunken Sailor, arranged by Alice Parker and Robert Shaw. This piece is a sea shanty, and it was originally sung to accompany certain work tasks aboard sailing ships in America. It has grown to be one of the best known songs in the shanty repertoire among mainstream audiences in America.
Thank you.
ahead of the coming trend, able to adapt to his style to any new wave of music. And there is no better example than in the case of his first hit, Alexander's Red Handmaid. Mrs. Charlotte Parker, Dr. Sarah Chan, and Dr. Rod Merle for sharing their talents with us.